This video was brought to you by the ILC. Hello there once again, welcome to episode 43. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to solve a system of two equations using a matrix. We're going to use a process called row reducing to solve the equations for both x and y because they'll contain two letters. Let's have a look. Alright, our system of equations contains both x and y. Our first equation is 2x plus 4y equals 6. Our second equation is 3x plus 2y equals 5. The first thing we'll do is create the matrix. Now, to create the matrix, we're going to make a matrix that has three columns. A column for x, a column for y, and a column for the constants. So in my first equation, I'll say 2, 4, 6. 2 underneath the x, 4 underneath the y, and 6 underneath the constant. The second equation will be 3, 2, 5, again in that order. Our goal for this matrix will be to reach what's called row echelon form. That means our goal is to change this number and this number to 1 along that diagonal. Our other goal for row echelon form will be to change this number in the corner to 0 so that we'll have zeros in the lower left corner, and along this diagonal line here we'll have 1s. The first thing we'll do to get row echelon form is to start in the upper left and get a 1 there first. To accomplish this, our first step will be to simply divide everything by 2. To show this, I'll write it in this notation. Take row 1, or R1 the way I've written it, divided by 2. So if my row 1 begins as 2, 4, 6, I'll simply divide each number by 2. So let's figure out what we should write. 2 divided by 2 is 1, 4 divided by 2 is 2, and 6 divided by 2 is 3. The second row does not change. It is still 3, 2, 5. My next step is to turn this number in the lower left-hand corner to 0. To accomplish this, I'm going to have to change row 2. I begin with 3, 2, and 5. Now, in a matrix, the easiest way to change something in row 2 to 0 is to add row 1 times something. I already have 1 up here. The first question we have to ask ourselves is, what is the opposite of 3? Because I have 3 here, my goal is to turn that 3 into a 0. But the opposite of 3 is negative 3. That's the number I'm going to need between the 3 and the 0. So the second question I need to ask myself is, what times the 1 that I have already will give me the negative 3 that I'm after? Well, 1 times negative 3 is what will give me negative 3. Now, it's not enough just to multiply the 1 times the negative 3, though. We have to multiply negative 3 times everything in row 1. So, first, negative 3 times 1 does give me negative 3. Negative 3 times 2 gives me negative 6. And negative 3 times 3 gives negative 9. Now we simply add. 3 minus 3 does indeed give 0. 2 minus 6 gives negative 4, and 5 minus 9 gives, also, negative 4. This is my new row 2. So let's write the matrix again. 1, 2, 3 is still my row 1. This doesn't change what row 1 is, it only changes row 2. My new row 2 is 0, minus 4, minus 4. There's only one more thing left to do here. We need to get this number, the second number in the second row, to 1, because we can have a 1 along this diagonal line still, right here. To do this, we'll take row 2 and divide it by this number to make it 1. So if we have 0, minus 4, minus 4, we'll simply divide all of them by minus 4. So, what's my new matrix? Now, this operation is only on row 2, so it does not change row 1. You still have 1, 2, 3. However, the second row, we'll take 0 over negative 4 is still 0, negative 4 over negative 4 is 1, and negative 4 over negative 4 is still 1. And this gets us to row echelon form. Now that we're in row echelon form, solving the matrix won't be too tricky. Let's have a look at that. Here's my matrix once again. To solve it, I'm going to start on the lowest row, that's row 2. Row 2 says I have 0x plus 1y equals the constant 1. That's not too tricky to solve. If this number was anything other than 1, we would just divide everything by 1. Of course, we know that doesn't make any difference. We simply have y equals 1. That's the first piece of our answer. Once we've done row 2, we're going to go up a row to row 1. Row 1 says we have 1x plus 2y equals the constant, 3. But we know that y is 1. Let's plug 1 in. 1x plus 2 times 1 equals 3. If we simplify, that gives us x plus 2 equals 3. To solve for x, simply subtract 2 from both sides. The 2's cancel. And so we'll have x equals 1. So our answer for this matrix is written inside of angular brackets. We'll just write x, comma, y. X is 1, comma, y is 1. And there you have it. In the next episode, I'll show you how to solve a matrix that has 3 variables, x, y, and z. We'll see you there.